Buongiorno amici, buongiorno. Hi guys, hi to all our friends from Italy together. Today we are in the amazing town of Montepulciano. Just entering in the town and let's go around, discover this beautiful town full of shops selling wine, but also a lot of beautiful streets and corners where you can come, take your beautiful pictures and enjoy this amazing town. So here we are, ready for our tour. Don't forget to send your comments, your likes and to subscribe to the channel for more and more videos. Andiamo amici. So you see, entering in the town, you will find a lot of these shops selling wine, and they also, or you can also visit the canteen of the shop.
Scusa, te lo lasciamo qua?
Aspetta, è già la testa.
Allora, mi devo lasciare anche il bigliettino?
Sì.
So guys, you enter in this shop and it's a real museum. Look at this, wow. So you can walk on the underground of the shop and see also the other rooms where they keep the wine for many years before they bottle. And it's a big canteen with big barrels, as you can see. Wow, look at this, very nice. So this is not just a shop, it's a shop together with the kind of tour in the history of this wine maker company. It's so beautiful, it's so fresh down here guys, and here you will really feel that the wine and this area, they are very much linked. So there are a lot of shops like this one where you can test the wine, visit the canteen, and then if you want you can buy some bottle. But this one is quite typical and original because they really let you make a tour underground and visit the different rooms of the shop. Wow, so nice. And then at the end, if you want, you buy a bottle. Otherwise, the tour is for free, but of course they do this because they hope that the clients at the end they will buy some product from the shop. So let's go here to the Stanza della Lana from the 16th century. So it's the room of the wool, and then also the Olaio from the 14th century. So it's where they were making the wine, the oil. With this machine they were smashing the olives and extracting the extra virgin olive oil from the olives. And here's some more big tank for the wine. And here different instruments used for the wool. You see here they give also some explanation. The wool room with the big wool combs. And here it's the Vin Santaglia where they were making the Vin Santo, also from the 14th century.
During this period of aging, the Vin Santo also tends to lose 25%. Sometimes they said even up to more than 50% of its volume. That's why they also have a very limited production of Vin Santo. The family, for example, they only more or less 1,200 bottles. Again, that's every 9 or 10 years since the first time they started producing Vin Santo. Again, that's 8 years in a small wooden cask, and then they let it sit in the bottles for another year or two before they put it up for sale. And then the only size that they produce is the 375 ml, so this small bottle right here. Okay.
So they also produce Vin Santo here. It's like a sweet wine used mainly with desserts here in Tuscany, or with a typical biscuit called Cantucci. Cantucci and Vin Santo, it's one of the most typical combination that you can have at the end of your dinner or of your lunch. Ah, look here. Look at this old room as well. And here some cheese. They are standing here for maturing. What a nice experience, guys, to be here. visit the shop, taste some wine, and then have a tour of this museum of the wine, of the oil, of the wool. Look at this one. For example, this one, it's an old torchio from the 15th century. It was used mainly for extracting the juice from the grapes. So they were putting the grapes here, then they were putting this big lid on top, and then this was going over to press and to extract the grapes. So they were extracting this juice from the grapes, and then was used for the wine production. And this is a nice tappatrice from the 18th century. Look at this one. Wow, so they were putting the lid, the cork lid on the bottle, and then they were pressing the lid on the bottle. And here there is an ancient well from the 16th century. So they said that if you put some coin, if you throw some coin, this well, it will give you lucky. This is the most crazy part of the tour, this Tampa Etrusca. This Etruscan Tampa, it's from the 4th century before Christ. Look, goes down there, and this one was an old Etruscan tomb. Wow, such a long history here in Montepulciano. And here the
vines.
Guarda, lassù gli mandano io. Cioè, da lassù gli mandano
So guys, after this tour in this nice canteen in the center of Montepulciano, let's keep walking around. So the entry in the canteen is for free. Then at the end, if you want, you can have a degustation of wine and some cheese and salami. And then if you want, you can buy some wine. Of course, they don't charge for the tour, but then they like when people, they buy the wine or other products from the shop. Thank you. so strong, the sun. Now it's about 32 degrees. So here the Church of Sant'Agostino.
Thank you.
So guys, we'll keep walking direction Duomo and the Fortezza Medicea. So also here when you come in Montepulciano, be prepared to walk and to do some steps if you want to go around. So at this time of the day, now it's 5 o'clock in the afternoon. You see the town quiet. See, even at this time of the day, also people they come for aperitivo and mainly to taste some wine. Some different aged wine from Tuscany, because this is the real tradition of Montepulciano. La chiesa del Gesù.
but suddenly had loads. And one was called James Point.
And
there's
two places
apart
from one
this corner. Here you can have a degustation of two different kinds of wine for 6 euros. So you choose which wine you want to try and they will give you a taste. And then if you like you buy the bottle, otherwise you can taste some more wine. So guys, few minutes and we are in Piazza Duomo, Dome Square. So you also have the possibility to come by bus. Or by car. Also here you can visit the canteen, Cantine Contucci. It's a free entry, and then if you want you buy some wine from the shop. And here, guys, finally we are in Piazza Duomo in Montepulciano. And here the beautiful Duomo, you can see the facade, it's not, it has never been finished, so it remain with these stones on the outside, but it's really nice, the Duomo, but not just the Duomo, but also the square. Look how beautiful it's here, guys. Wow. And here, also, once you arrive here, you want to rest, have some relax, and then this is the bus you can take to go up and down in Montepulciano. In case you don't want to walk, then you can use this bus. If you want to go to the tower, here Piazza Duomo, then you can also go here and pay 5 euro to enter in the tower, to go up and see the panorama from the tower.
Thank you.
parcă am fost pe lui, am fost acolo. Și aveați în spate și tot așa, că la el face poza și după aia o așează singuri.
Wow, ceva. Guys, look at the panorama here.
Și a dat un pic.
Amazing.
Da, parcă, da,
parcă this is like a big panorama painted by the nature. Look how beautiful it is, wow. And with this light at this time of the day, it's perfect.
Ahí hemos estado nosotros. Con el tren. ¿Ya habéis bajado?
No.
Fíjate, o sea que bajáis hasta ahí abajo y luego subís.
So now let's go to the Fortezza Medicea, which is another attraction of Montepulciano, and from there we will enjoy a bit more the panorama of this typical town of Tuscany. Thank you. guys, here we arrive to the Fortezza Medicea. You can enter, the entry is for free, and now it has been transformed in some office, and it's also an enoteca. And then in this Enoliteca you have a panoramic terrace, and you can also visit the archaeological site. So here it's the wine shop where you can have also degustation of wines. You can choose your bottle, drink your bottle of wine over this big archaeological site. Wow, look at this mess. It's like big tanks used mainly to store water many, many years ago. Wow, incredible. Incredible the atmosphere, but imagine, guys, to be here and to drink your wine over an archaeological site. Wow, and here this wonderful terrace. So you come here, you have your wine. And that's the panorama that you will have. So from there the panorama is amazing, but also here on the other side of Monte Pulciano, look at this wonderful view you have. Nice, no words, really beautiful. And the location of Monte Pulciano, as you can see, it's perfect because it's on the top of the valley from where you can really enjoy this view. Wow. So guys, this was Monte Pulciano. Very, very nice tour today, guys, all together, like a big family traveling around Italy and discovering the beauty of this country. There are really a lot of places and towns that we have to visit. Most of them, some of them we already discovered together, but still a lot of places and walk we have to do together. So send your comments, your likes, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more and more videos, guys. So we keep going around and discover the beauty of Italy all together. Grazie a tutti, amici, and see you from this wonderful view of Val di Chiana Senese. Ciao ciao.
Kakav streber, brate, ono, kao on dopunjava,
ono, čao.
U glavu, brate, ono, nešto. Ajde, dijebi, brate.
Aha, brate, to se zadnji došao.
Pustalo se.
Na njega ne vrata.
Na ovo je lovi,
brate.
Ha?
Na njega se pustalo.
Dobra, ono je kao iz filma, brate, 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 iz filma